Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is BestInSlot, and despite it being my day off, we are going to do a new weekly Q&A type session thing. We're doing this separate from the blog, so each weekend I can do a vlog-like video like we did yesterday, and I can do a Q&A type session, and every week we're going to play a new random game, and the game of choice this week is the absolutely phenomenal Rogue Legacy. So I'm just going to get through this. I've started a new character, just for the sake of this video. And I'm just going to get through this opening little bit before I start the questions. Now, you have left a billion questions. I apologize if yours didn't quite make it. I think I got like 98% of them. Some people left like 500 questions, so I kind of ignored them, basically, to put it in a really nice way. But I've got the vast majority of your questions. As per usual, there will be a comment thread below if you've got anything else you want to ask, if you want any game recommendations for next week. Next week, we are going to play Mountain Blade, I believe, because somebody recommended I played at some point, so we're going to give Mountain Blade a go next week for the next Q&A, but after that you'll be able to leave game recommendations, just weird little things, basically. I haven't played this in such a long time. Oh, as you can pretty much tell. And these give me secret things of happiness. Just let me be finished, right? Okay, let's get started with the Q&A. The problem with this game is, right, this is a very twitchy playing kind of game. To play this and answer questions at the same time is ridiculous. So, if you could have a relationship with a dinosaur, what dinosaur would it be? This is a strange question. I thought you should know. But, okay, that's how I do that. If I could have a relationship with a dinosaur... Well, you'd want a... I don't want a relationship with a dinosaur. I'm going to put this out there. I have no interest in a romantic relationship with a dinosaur. If you had to have one... You may as well have one that's somewhat useful in some way, you know? A dinosaur that's going to assist you. So, like, a Triceratops or something would be good as, like, a guard dog to an extent. And would also... Oh, crikey. Bit hectic. Ah! Triceratops would be a good guard dog. And you'd also be able to use it to, like, take you to work or something. So that'd be fun. Bloody flying things. So Triceratops. That's what we're going for. For now. It depends what you mean by relationship. What do I have to do with the dinosaur? Because that's an issue. Sorry. this was a bad choice of game. You have to concentrate far too much. For those who don't know, Rogue Legacy is basically a roguelike where you are meant to die. Everyone dies billions of times. But your character gets better. You get better characters and that much. Opinion on early access on Steam. I like early access. I think it's a good idea, but I think the problem is a lot of developers have started to abuse it as an idea. In that, nope. People started to abuse the idea in that, you know, as soon as their game basically exists, people are sticking it on early access, making a lot of money, and then they don't really have any reason to develop the game as much anymore. Again, like what's happening with the Stomping Land. They went on early access, got a load of money, and then what's the point in carrying on? Because they've made all their cash. So, to that extent, it's not been fantastic. Sweet! Okay, next question. What is your favourite Ice Age creature? I don't know. The giant sloth that I've completely forgotten the name of is pretty damn cool. Titanoboa, though, I think has to... Ow. Ah! Is Titanoboa even Ice Age? I don't even know. But either way, I'm going to say Titanoboa, and if I'm wrong, I'm wrong. But I'm saying Titanoboa for now, okay? Deal with it! So Titanoboa is my answer. Oh no, Giant Sloth. I can't remember what it's called. Somebody's going to tell me. I know you are, but... I do know I've got one just about Builder. There's so many questions, guys. Favourite zombie game? Walking Dead. Yeah, Walking Dead, for now. Weirdest prehistoric creature has to be... Weirdest prehistoric creature really has to be Therizinosaurus, doesn't it? It's bizarre, it's a freak. No! Okay. Did you talk to your landlord about animals? No, I don't really know who my landlord is or where he exists. So, it's all a little strange at this point in time. What's that? Gotta focus. Bloody Nora game, you're not half making me do stuff here. What have we got? Architect, nope, don't care about that. Okay. Upgrade the mana pool as well. Oh yeah, whoopsie daisy. Hello! Welcome hero, blah 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 blah. I don't have anything, do I? No, of course not. Okay! I will talk to my landlord. I do want a pet. I want something quiet. People keep recommending like a bearded dragon, and I think that's a good idea. A bearded dragon would be really cool. Or a iguana or something. Or a chameleon. I don't know yet. Will you play Warframe? I actually have a video. I believe I have a video on Warframe on the channel somewhere. I remember doing a video on Warframe. If you go onto my multiplayer games playlist, I think there's a video of Warframe in there. I didn't love the game, but I have an aversion to free-to-play games. I just always have done, really. So, Warframe, whilst I was quite good, it's not going to be like a thing, you know? I might give it another go one day. I mean, I've not played it in, it must be at least a year, so I'm sure the game's updated plenty since then. Okay, do you have any pets? I feel like this is like the most common question besides what is your favourite dinosaur. In terms of pets, I mean, I've got a cat. Technically, I mean, it's not really my cat. It is the family's cat. I hate these things. It's like the family's cat, you know? It's not really mine. It doesn't respond to me. It doesn't really know I exist or anything. But it's a nice enough little cat. What is your favourite carnivorous dinosaur? I got asked this last week, and you know what? I still don't really know. What did I say last time? I like Acrocanthosaurus. I like Baryonyx, because it's British. I like Ceratosaurus. I don't know what I'd put as my favourite, I'm afraid. No help to you there. Ba-ba-da-bing! Blade Wall. Rubbish spell. Don't know why I went for it. Mountain Blade, I've responded. Will you play Slenderman for 100k? Now, I have actually done videos on Slenderman in the past. I've actually got quite a few videos on Slenderman. I've got at least 3 or 4 videos on Slenderman, so if you want to go watch them... Oh, crikey, okay. Nope, failed. No, I haven't failed. Go, 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 go! Yes! Phew! Right, basically, these are things called fairy chests, which, to get to them, you have to do a very difficult challenge, so it's... That's making it through this horrible room without killing anything. Without fighting at all. And if you do it, you get a rune. And a rune basically is like a permanent upgrade to your character's abilities that you activate later on. They're very important. Now, this is a boss room. I'm nowhere near capable of killing this boss at this point in time, so we're going to skip. Oh, God! Where'd you come from? Ah! Right. Next question. Where were we? Slenderman. So there is Slenderman things out there. So if you want to watch them, you can do. Damn it, I nearly had him. But I'm not going to do a Slenderman for 100k, that thing, because I'm not really a fan of Slenderman, I've got to be honest. Wait for the eye to shoot at me. There we go. However, somebody did... No, that was always going to happen. Somebody did leave a suggestion for 100k, which I really liked. It was like, what I'll do is I'll do like a week off playing all the games that we used to play on the channel that kind of started... the channel in the first place, kind of thing. Like Skyrim and the original Walking Dead and all this kind of stuff. And I really liked it as an idea. I think we're definitely gonna do that. Probably. I'm not gonna say definitely because it's still an idea, but I like it as an idea. It's a cool idea. Okay. Will you twerk for 100k? Will I hell? No. I will not twerk for 100k. I'm sorry. There will be no twerking on this channel. If God is my witness, there will be no twerking. Oh, I do have a... Oh, I'm a silly goose. I've got plenty of new equipment. I should have been buying all that. Equipment is more important than everything. Where are my runes? How do I activate runes? Or the auto? Or have I messed this up somehow? I have no idea. Anyways. How would you kill someone? Yeah, basically, if you really hated someone, how would you kill them? Violent question, to say the least. But, you know what, if I really hated someone, this is why I'm against the death penalty as well. If I really hate someone, I wouldn't really kill them. For one thing, I don't think I could actively... Unless somebody, like, let's say somebody murdered my entire family, right? I think I could kill them. I'm just going to put this out there. I'm pretty confident in my ability. I think I'd murder them without too much hesitation, frankly. I'm going to leave you alone. But other than that, there's not many things people could do to make me want to murder them. And even if they did, I mean, murdering someone doesn't really... I don't want to say it doesn't achieve anything, because revenge is awesome in a lot of ways, and bad in a lot of ways. I'm trying to be helpful here, but I shouldn't tell people that revenge is good, but yeah, there's nothing wrong with a bit of revenge in my opinion. But the fact is, like the death penalty, right? Bugger. I'm getting ruined. Basically, I was nearly MLG. If you really hate someone and you want someone to suffer, surely killing them is like the worst way to do it. Surely the best way to handle it is... you know, you want them to suffer throughout their whole life, so sending them to jail for the rest of their life, solitary confinement, is a far worse punishment, as far as I'm concerned, than the death penalty. And same would apply with murdering someone who has betrayed me. I will duel them at dawn with pistols. Where are we up to? Seri Plays. Have you heard of Seri Plays? No. But this is basically someone asking me if I've heard of another YouTuber. Honestly, I've heard of about 6 YouTubers. I've heard of Markiplier, PewDiePie, because I like... huge. Markiplier, PewDiePie... Oh god, I didn't see you. Ow! Pucker off! I should be able to get you, come on. Markiplier, PewDiePie, PokePlays, Yogscast, Jacksepticeye, because he does a lot of Oculus Rift stuff. And you know what? That is pretty much it in terms of my knowledge of YouTubers. I don't really know many YouTubers. I don't really watch YouTube that much. I know it sounds weird. I don't really have time for YouTube to sit and watch YouTube stuff half the time. It's a bit strange. I'm sure there's lots of great YouTubers out there. I just don't really know them. But no, I haven't heard of Seri Plays. I should probably keep up to date with YouTubers more, but I don't. Name a dinosaur. If I could name a dinosaur, what would I call it? I don't know. BestInSlotosaurus? I don't like that, see. I don't really like that. I don't think I'd want to name it after myself. So we'll call it like Butterbinkysaurus or something. Butterosaurus. Binkysaurus. Clementinodon. I like that. Nah, damn. Not my best. Sir Fleming has been slain by a zombie. Sweet. Paladin. Okay, we're going Paladin. Who do we like? Oh, he's got bloody black and whiteness. Okay, so we're going to get some equipment. Plus 16 armor. Beautiful. Let's get that. Oh, I can't afford it. Can I afford you? Yeah. Can I afford you? Yeah. Okay. New shiny equipment that you can't see the difference because... Oh, love that. Well, because it's black and white. Okay, where are we up to? Name a dinosaur, I say. And somebody said we're going to talk about music. So this is going to take a minute because it's not really a question. It's just me blabbering on about music. Because I love music. All I do is listen to music. I'm annoyed that I'm not listening to music right now, frankly. So when it comes to music, the main things I listen to... I know a few of you have like gone on to my song recommendations in the past and I actually quite like the music. So if you are into the type of music I've recommended in the past, you'll probably like this stuff. Basically, look at the new sword. It kills me in one hit. It's awesome. Hell of a room, this. So the main type of music I like is kind of pop rock, rock, punk, folk music, that kind of thing. If there's not a guitar involved, I'm usually not that interested. Saying that, Say Anything, which is one of my favourite bands, recently did an album called Hebrews, which does not have a single guitar on it, which is strange considering they are a pretty much a pop rock, pop punk, punk band, basically. Well, not really punk, but pop punk. But I don't like using... I hate the word pop punk because it implies poppiness and people associate pop with bad music, and the fact is pop rock is awesome. A lot of the good stuff is anyway. So Say Anything released an album called Hebrews, which is really, really good by the way. And that's... Sorry, this might take a bit of focus. And that's really, really good. That's got no guitars whatsoever. And it's a really, really, really good album. But generally speaking, shouldn't have done that. It's music with a... Sorry, one sec. music with guitars. So at the moment, the band I'm absolutely in love with is called Aaron West and the Roaring Twenties. Aaron West. Yeah, A-A-R-O-N. This basically is a side project by the lead singer of the Wonder Years, which is like my favourite pop punk band. This guy called Dan Campbell, Soupy to his friends, seemingly. Don't know why, but Soupy. And it's like a... basically... Yeah, that's gonna happen. Come here! Ow! Stop it! It's basically, he's done this album, like this folky, acoustic-y, poppy, rocky album based on a made-up character called Aaron West. And it's just phenomenal. There's a few songs in particular, Running Scared, Divorce in the American South, which is heartbreaking. What else is there? There's those two, and... there's a few, just check out the whole album. The main track is really good as well, I can't remember what it's called for some reason. But just if you're into that kind of music, I recommend it. Aaron West and the Roaring Twenties. So that's my main thing at the moment. I'm also listening to a band called Weatherbox, which I believe is one guy, I'm not 100% sure. One song in particular called Bathing in the Fuss, which is like about French Revolution and stuff, and it's a very ironic kind of song, and it's fantastic as well. So Weatherbox and Aaron West and Roaring Twenties are my main two at the moment. But I listen to lots. I want to go up there. I don't. Ah! Meow. There better be something good up. Oh, there's a chest. Okay. This is worth it then. Hep. 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 Phew. These blueprints are what you use to get the items that we saw before. So they're very helpful. Go, go, go. Go, go. Ah! Okay, cool beans. Music. We've done music. Where are we up to? 100k Blast from the Past. Yep, that was a great idea. Thank you for that. Update on Berk. I am going to update Rise of Berk. I know it's updated recently. Like, they've added Mega Dragons or something. And I am definitely going to do, like, update videos on it every now and again. It's going to be like Dress Part Builder. I'm still going to play it. It's just going to be a lot rarer than it was, basically. Oh, bugger. I thought I had that. What are you up to? Favourite superhero? What is my favourite superhero? I don't know. Oh, Barbarian King. Axe. No, I don't like that one. Chicken's freaking out. That's okay. We're going to keep our gold because I want to buy equipment, basically. There we go. Lots of armour. Just makes you a bit tougher. Look at me. I'm a badass. Right. I don't know. Interesting. Favorite superhero? Hummity. I have no idea. Why don't I know this? Actually, I've got no idea. I've got to be honest, guys. I've got no idea. In terms of films... well, no. See, my Avengers superhero... Avengers would be my favorite superhero film, so that doesn't really help. I quite like Nighthawk? Whoever the hell Jeremy Renner played in Avengers, just because he's like, he's not, come here! He's not really a superhero, he's just like, this guy who's awesome with a bow. He's basically Torok, or Lara Croft, or whatever. He's just some dude with a bow. Does he count as a superhero though? Probably not. I'll get back to you on that one. Maybe. I like the Hulk, but only since he's played by Mark Ruffalo. Unmodded Zoo Tycoon 2, will you play it? I will... eventually. There's a whole... crikey. Okay, then. About to go MLG all over this. I don't know how I did that. For the life of me, I don't know how I did that. But it's working again. Oh, that was beautiful. I'm so proud of myself. I will play it again sometime, Zoo Tycoon 2 with no mods, I'll just make a zoo or something, but it is down the line, loads of games before, lots of games to play before I go back and play old games, basically. Wildlife Park 2, I have downloaded, I've got the Ultimate Edition, and we're definitely going to play that in the future. Will you play The Plan? Never heard of it, but we'll have a look. Favourite dinosaur movie? That's a silly question. I'm sorry, that's a very silly question. let's be honest, in terms of dinosaur films, we have limited options beyond Jurassic Park anyway, to the point where I actually can't think of any off the top of my head. Why can't I think of any? Land of the Lost, I suppose. That's rubbish. Colour and animal. Favourite colour and animal. Is that what you asked? I actually don't know. Favourite colour? It used to be blue. For the longest time, my favourite colour was blue. Oh, crikey. This is actually the only way I can go. Nope, didn't work. Hep. Nope, didn't work. Ah! Blue for ages, and now it's probably... I like a reddish orange, like a fire orange. So, yeah, let's go with that. And favourite animal that's not prehistoric, I believe was the question. Ow. Bugger off, come here. Ow! What am I doing? I like praying mantises. I really like the praying mantis for some reason. I really like Komodo dragons because they basically look like little dinosaur type things. They're probably my big two. Praying mantis as well because it looks like Cypher. Well, Cypher's based off the praying mantis and Cypher's awesome. In case you didn't know that. Okay, so that's what I'll go with for now. Praying mantis for now. It's probably not, but I need to think harder about it. I like armadillos. Have you seen Godzilla 2014? Not yet. I actually haven't. I've obviously missed my chance. I'm really excited to watch it as well. I pretty much bought my new TV, which is quite a nice little TV. Well, big TV. For the purpose of watching Godzilla and Gravity in like proper big HD. So I'm waiting for Godzilla to hit the internet, basically. Or to be buyable or whatever. Let's go with that, shall we? If you could have a role in the new Jurassic Park film, what would it be and how would you be eaten? Do I have to be eaten? Can I be the hero? I don't know. I think they need someone who actually... And the problem is with the new film, they don't really have anyone... I suppose they got Woo, but they need like a hero who actually knows about dinosaurs. They need like a new Alan Grant. I'll be that. How would I get eaten? Well, I wouldn't get eaten in that situation. Although I do, I'm okay with a hero dying. I actually quite like it when people kill off the main character. Makes me happy, except in horror films. And that's only because every horror film does it these days. It would surprise me more when somebody... no reason to go in there. It would surprise me more if... What is that? It would surprise me more if a main character survived in a horror film rather than died. And when it gets to that point, it's time to stop doing it, basically, as far as I'm concerned. So... Wait, why am I talking about horror films? I actually can't remember. If I had to die... Oh, if you're curious to get in there, you have to... Basically, every now and again, you get a trait called dwarfism, and it makes you tiny. You'll be able to jump in there. It's the only way to do it. How would I die? What would I like? I'd like to be killed by a herbivore. If not, I didn't want to kill by a herbivore, really, except... Come here, chicken! That damn chicken. I need the health as well, but... Chicken! Chicken! Phew! Thank God for that. Oh, this might be a new level, actually. Okay. Oh, nope, not ready for that. Not ready for that at all. That's like the hardest one. Never mind. Okay. Yeah, like a Triceratops getting... Ooh! Phew. Like getting gored by a Triceratops would be awesome. I mean, it wouldn't. It'd be very painful. But I'm saying, in terms of a death, people would remember it, you know? And it'd be nice for the Triceratops to get to its moment in the sunshine a little bit. I don't know where to... Oh, God, I have to go all the way back. Okay. Next question. You guys left a lot of questions. I appreciate it. It's cool. How tall are you? I am 6'2". 6'2". So, it was like, are you short, medium, or... I think... Right, at 6'2", I don't consider myself tall, but in terms of the average height, I am... Somewhat. Nah, I can't bother with that. I am over average in terms of height, but I don't consider myself like tall in particular. Are you old enough to get wasted? Obviously. I've been old enough to get wasted for the past 5 years now. I'm 23, by the way. You suggested I was 25, which is fine, but I don't want to be 25. I don't want to be 23. I want to go back to like 21. 21's a nice age. When you're 21, guys, appreciate it. 21's awesome. It's like the perfect age of just about old enough and mature enough, but still young enough to justify going out every night kind of thing. It's perfect. Next question. Do you believe in Bigfoot? You know what? I kind of do. There's so many correlated reports across such a wide expanse of time that I believe. And we've got footprints and stuff, and footprints that would be very hard to fake, and all this kind of malarkey. I believe in Bigfoot. I believe in Sherlock Holmes. No, I do. I believe in Bigfoot. Something say it's actually. Bigfoot, T-Rex. Right, who do you have a fight with? T-Rex, Velociraptor, Edmontosaurus, or Torosaurus? Well, Velociraptor, obviously. Velociraptor's teeny tiny tiny dinosaur. Panicked. Roller Coaster Tycoon 3. I did say I'll play this, and I am going to play Roller Coaster Tycoon 3, just not yet. It is on my list of games, but it is low on the list of games at this point in time. Let's play the Queen. The Queen's awesome, by the way, and you'll see why. Look at it, she's got a little bow on her head. That's adorable. What did we get? I got new equipment now, didn't I? Oh, we got a cape. Sweet. 4% critical. Yeah, go on. I want a cape anyway, because capes are awesome. Can I get the helmet as well? Okay, that is me stocked up in terms of equipment. I look beautiful. And 65 gold left, sweet. Okay. I will play Roller Coaster Tycoon 3 one day, I really will, but it isn't high on the list. I've done a lot of tycoon-y, management-y type games recently. I'd like to settle back from that a little bit. And while we're on the point of that kind of thing, I would like to say that I'm not a nature channel. This is a weird thing for me to say. Or to have to say. Uh-oh. Ah! You crazy son of a bitch! Come here. You're not getting- ow! Ah! Ah! Come here! I don't care if I die, as long as you die. I'm not a nature-based channel. You know, I like nature and animal games and stuff, but I'm not, by any stretch of the imagination, a nature-focused channel. That isn't my thing. We are half a dinosaur channel, where I will always have at least one dinosaur game running, but things like The Last of Us and big RPG games, you know, at the end of the day, that's where the channel got started, is big-ass RPG games. Don't know how I dodged that, I really don't. So, while I appreciate guys like certain type of video and stuff, I did get a comment the other day like saying, oh, why are you playing this? Shouldn't you be playing a nature game or something? That's what your channel's about. And I was just like, well, that's not really what the channel's about in the slightest. The channel is about all types of things. Dinosaurs mainly. Well, not even mainly, just half dinosaurs and half whatever the hell I feel like playing, basically, to sum up the situation. And yeah, we may do a preference for nature games because there's a lot of awesome nature games out there, including, and I'll lead this into a follow-up question, somebody asked, am I going to play Sea Monsters? Apparently Sea Monsters, oh crikey, is an atrocious game and has really bad controls. However, I will play it at some point. Probably not a full series, but we'll do at least an episode. But I have heard nothing but bad things about Sea Monsters, I'm afraid. But I will definitely give it a go. Just gotta try it for them once, well, not everything, most things. Anything that won't kill you. Okay, so I just want to get that out of there. Not a nature channel. Not a nature channel in the slightest. Just like animals. May play. I mean, I'm still rolling around the idea of a second channel. I posted this on the Facebook page. Basically, a second channel. So, let's say Dragon Age Inquisition comes out, which I'm really excited for, or The Witcher 3, which I'm really excited for. You know, all these games coming out that I really, really want to play, but they take a very long time to complete. You know, the huge games. Maybe I don't want to put them on this channel. I am considering a second channel for that. But that isn't a let's split the nature games from the RPG games or anything. That is simply because the other games are humongous, and I don't really want to do a like 100 episode series on the main channel anymore. Basically, that's the thinking behind it. Okay, so that's sorted. Where are we up to? Primal Carnage. Will you play Primal Carnage? I will play lots and lots of Primal Carnage. As soon as the next update hits, I will be all over it. Yo. Do you believe in Loch Ness Monster? What do you think about Loch Ness Monster? It doesn't exist. The difference between Loch Ness Monster and like Bigfoot, for example, is Bigfoot has this wide open. By the way, I believe in Yeti more than Bigfoot, but whatever. Does that make sense? No, that doesn't make sense. I've got no health. I can't do the boss. The Bigfoot, or the Yeti, or whoever, doesn't really matter, has this wide open expanse to survive in without being spotted, whereas the Loch Ness Monster has a lake. It's a big lake? It's not even that big a lake. So, we would have found some evidence of the Loch Ness Monster by now. I don't believe in most cryptozoological creatures, just because I think by this point in time there would be evidence. Now, admittedly, we do find new creatures all the time, so obviously I'm not closed off to the idea about new creatures, because we do, we find new creatures constantly. However, a lot of cryptozoological creatures are rather large. Ah! No! That's so rude! So, most of them we would have found evidence of by now, in my opinion. Tell you what. No, no, I can't do it. It's not letting me do it. No, mind. Let's try this one out. Right, Oh, I did get new equipment. I got a blood sword. I love the blood sword. I probably can't afford it, though. Let's just get some health. And find out how much the blood sword is, so next time we can get it. 500. I could have afforded it. Bugger. Blood sword is really good. It does less damage, and it's pretty heavy. But it does less damage than the next sword up. But it gives you health back with every hit, or every kill, or something. Right. Godzilla, 2K, walking. Walking with dinosaurs. Have you seen walking? I love walking with dinosaurs. Walking with dinosaurs is one of the things that got me into dinosaurs in the first place when I was a kid. I used to... When it first hit TV, everyone was inviting me out that night to go around, go play football or something at the park, and I was like, no, Walking with Dinosaurs is on, I'm never leaving the house again, basically. Walking with Dinosaurs is so good, and the fact that the film sucks makes me so sad. Beyond belief. Beyond belief. It upsets me. I really don't like mage characters in this game. Cool spell though, isn't it? Very cool spell. Hedgehog's Curse. I really don't know what most of these things do, I've got to be honest with you. Where are we up to? Will you play Never or Rust again? I probably won't play Never again. Maybe do one episode. Never know. But we're probably not going to play Never again. Rust, however. Okay, let's figure this out. Nope, did not work. Am I losing goals when I get hit? What is that all about? Uh-oh. Rust, however, Rust is like going under like a big, big update where they're basically releasing the second version of the game, and as soon as that comes out, we'll be all over that. I'll probably do another series on Rust when that hits. Likewise, Dino D-Day. Dino D-Day is a weird game, because I don't think Dino D-Day is actually a good game, personally. I think it's quite a bad game. In a lot of... Oh my god. That was rubbish. That was really, really bad. I hate the mage character. Dino D-Day I don't think is a good game, frankly. I'm going to swap to my other character, who's a little bit more... built, shall we say. Hello. Oh, this is how you activate your runes as well. I forgot about this. This is why I couldn't do it on the other one. Damage returned to enemies. What am I using? Double jump. It's better. And we're using lots of balance ones. Cool. Look at my character. She's a hero. Yeah, I don't really like Dino D-Day. It's okay. We're going to play it down the line again because it's a dinosaur game and I will inevitably play it again. That's just kind of the lore. But it doesn't do much for me, I've got to be honest. So you have to kill two bosses in this character. Only two. Any more than that would be ridiculous. It's a hard game, guys. It's a hard game. What is your favourite Friends character? Now everybody's going to be expecting me to say Ross here, but you know what? It's not Ross. It's definitely Chandler. It just is. If I'm going for the third boss, I need to go up. Yeah. So what we're trying to do is to get to the third level. Basically, this level, which is this boss, you go far to the right, that gets you into the forest, and that's got the second boss. You go far to the top, that gets you to the third boss. You go far to the bottom, that gets you to the fourth boss. You can do them in any order, but that is the accepted order of how difficult they are, basically. Where's this? This basically takes you to a random place. This is actually where I wanted to go, oddly enough. Got a lot of stuff that gives me health and mana and stuff when I hit things, so... where are we up to? Best Theropod. Oh no, what is my... Oh, this is the boss. Oh. Oh no. I'm not ready for this. Tell you what, guys. Well, this is the third boss in the game out of four. Actually, I think there's a final one after that. So, well, let's see what this is like. I don't think I've ever tried this before. Oh, no, I have. I remember this. Oh, God. It wouldn't be this blurry usually. It's because of one of the traits my characters has got. Wait, I know. I haven't... Ah! Not a good start there. Bugger off! Bugger off! Bloody! It's war of attrition, ladies and gentlemen. It's a war of attrition. It's war of attrition, I'm definitely gonna lose, but it's war of attrition. Nope, got trapped. Bugger. It's horrible. It's horrible, it really is. From the bottom of my heart, it's horrible. Hockage is awesome. Where are we up to? Would you rather have hands for feet or feet for hands? It's a hard question. It's a strange question, but it's a hard question. Would I rather have hands for feet or feet for hands? I don't know. Would I rather have hands for feet or feet for hands? Well, if you've got feet for hands, let's think about this logically. If your hands are feet, you can pick anything up. If your feet were hands, then you could probably still walk, and if anything, you'd have better grip on things. So definitely feet for hands. That was actually easier than I thought. Beer or rum, which is better? Beer, by a considerable margin. I hate rum with a fervent passion, I really do. I don't really have any vampirism, do I? No, I do. I definitely do. Oh, it's kills that get me health. Right. Is that better? No, 10% gold bonus. That's rubbish. Where am I up to? Yeah, definitely beer. I don't like rum ever since... I mean, I can do rum and coke. Ish. Not a fan. But I had a night out in... I had a night out in York about 4 years ago, and I was already very, very drunk, and I got a drink called an evil zombie, which the name, the name alone wasn't filling me with confidence, to be honest, but there's this drink called an evil zombie, and it's like 7 types of rum in a pint glass, and I drank it, and then I died forever. And I'm still dead from that night. So, no, ever since that night, I have a somewhat aversion to rum, to be honest. Which I believe is somewhat understandable, considering the circumstances. Okay, so, no, beer. Beer, everyone loves beer. Football as a kid, did you play football as a kid, in what position? I did, I love football, Liverpool. We beat AC Milan 2-0 last night, it was beautiful, and we're playing Man United tomorrow in the International Guinness Champions Cup thingamajiggy. It's rubbish, it's basically a pre-season friendly tournament, and it makes people all excited, despite the fact, at the end of the day, okay, we all want to beat Man United, but it is a pre-season friendly, no matter what happens, you know, it's for fitness more than anything else, so it's really not a big deal. But it's nice to win, and especially when it's against Man United, so I am living in hope. I played lots of football as a kid, but we mainly played a game called Heads and Creds, which is basically... How do you explain Heads and Creds? Basically, a lot of people call it Heads and Volleys. It's basically the same principle. You have to... Somebody's in net, and they can't use their hands, and... Other people have to volley the ball into the net, and if you don't volley it, so you're trying to set each other up for a volley, and if you don't volley it, then you go in net next. And if someone scores past you with a volley while you're in net, you can use your hands, I don't know why I said that, then you lose a life, and first person to lose all their lives loses lives. That's mainly what we did. When we played normal, I was either in defence or goal, really. I'm a defender, because everyone else was tiny and I wasn't, basically. Will you play Magic the Gathering? I don't like Magic the Gathering, I've got to be honest. I know it's like Hearthstone and it's a card game and stuff, but Magic just never really did it for me. Don't know why. FIFA. Will you play FIFA on the channel? Now, this is one reason I want a second channel. I will never play FIFA on this channel, probably. I don't think FIFA fits this channel in a lot of ways. And like I said, this channel is partly, you know, I'm just going to play whatever I feel like playing kind of thing. But I am aware that I have a certain audience to an extent. And, okay, while some of that audience may want FIFA, by and large, I don't think most of it does. So, whilst I love FIFA, I really do. Ow, that was rubbish. Pucker off! Come here! Stop that! It's probably not something I'm going to play on this channel. If I do set up the second channel, which is still a maybe at this point in time, then I will definitely consider FIFA down the line. Okay? Cool beans. Nah, I need more health. I'm not going in there without full health. Pokemon. Will you play the old Pokemon games? I'd like to do that. Like I said, I have played Pokemon Black 2 in the past, which is quite fun actually, so let's play, I think. The problem with the old Pokemon games is they're huge, basically, and again, it's... Nope, I don't care that much about the chest. Well, maybe I do. No, I do. Hopefully it's not gold. Hopefully it's something, you know, valuable. Not gold. Oh, for God's sake. Whew! Don't want gold! I want bloody armor or something. There we go. That's how it's done. That's how it's done. Where are we up to? Not many questions left. So, that's the Pokemon thing. It's a maybe. I'd love to sit down. Pokemon Red was such a huge part of my childhood. I'd love to go back and play it sometime, but it's not super likely. I'm not going to lie to you. We'll see. At the end of the day, right, let's say the child runs for another 4 or 5 years at least. It's a minimum of 4 in my head, because I've got 3 years of university to go after this. So I've got this year, then 3 years after this. And I don't see me stopping in those 4 years. So it's at least 4 years. I'm going to run out of games to play sometime, so there's always a chance for everything. We play the Sea Monsters game. I've already mentioned that. The first piece of clothing I own. 20... Okay, ladies and gentlemen, basically you're giving 25% of your money and then you have the potential for a super duper chest. What do we like? I'm feeling the middle. And that's why you feel the middle. Wait a minute. Sweet. Daphrus clothing. Yeah, sorry, got distracted. I've just got a new coat actually, and the coat is beautiful. It's like it's big wool type thing, and it's really nice. It's one of those like when you see businessy type men walking down the street on the way to work in the cold and stuff. It's kind of one of those cuts, but it looks really, really nice. So that's pretty dapper. It's pretty dapper. And final question, Spinosaurus or Ankylosaurus? Who would win consistently in a fight? Oh no, we're going to do that on Operation Genesis Dinosaur Battles at some point soon. But who would I vote for? I think I'd vote for the Spinosaurus definitely has the size advantage to an extent, but Ankylosaurus has got so much armor. I'm going for the Spankylosaurus. Spankylosaurus is something very different. Ah! Not a fan of your work, I'm going to tell you that for free. And I'm out of mana. Bugger off! Come on. God damn it. I'm really bad at that. I can't take another hit either. No! It was a tricky chest! A tricky chest! No! Oh. Okay, that's enough of that. That's actually very well timed with the final question as well. So, apologies, this is all a bit haphazard and stuff, but it's quite hard for me to do this and play a game like Rogue Legacy, so I need to play something a little slower in the future, I think. But that is Sunday's Q&A. We'll be back next Sunday. Sunday is my day off, so it's not regular content, but I figured a day off is quite a good day to do a Q&A, because I basically just sit here and read questions out and play a random game that I'm in the mood for, basically. So, thank you very much for the questions. There should be a comment thread below if you want to leave any for next week. We will hit a point fairly soon. I might change this, guys. I might change this to basically, I'm going to pick like the 5 best questions and do a quick shot webcam type video where I answer those questions. I don't know, we'll see. We shall see. I will have a think. But I'll leave a comment for it anyway, just in case, and I shall see you lovely people next week. Thank you very much for joining me. Cheers, much love, bye-bye.